Hello, and welcome to Church of St. Vincent's, as today we celebrate the 18th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Just a reminder that the bishop has requested, due to COVID protocols in place, that the congregation refrain from singing out loud during Mass. Please keep the music in your heart, the Lord with you. Let us begin our celebration. Please stand.
Peace. You may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who gathers us here in the Holy Spirit to be one with one another and one with you, our God, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Taking 5 loaves and 2 fish. He looked up to heaven, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them, who in turn gave it to his disciples, who in turn gave it to the people. This is the language and the actions that he used at his last supper, where he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them, and where he took the cup of wine, blessed it again, and passed it among themselves. And so I think what St. Matthew's Gospel is trying to do, in no uncertain terms, is to show us the connection between the miracle of feeding the 5,000, but scripture scholars claim that there were about 20,000 because women and children were not counted. There's a connection between that miracle and the miracle of the Eucharist. In today's gospel, Jesus is ministering to the physical needs of the people. But while he's doing that, he's also asking them about their faith in him. Everything that Matthew says throughout the course of his gospel points to the fact that Jesus wanted to give himself to his people, to us. And he did that ultimately through the gift of the Eucharist. Notice the challenge that he had given to the disciples. There is no need for them to go anywhere, to go home. Give them something to eat yourselves. His disciples seemingly shrugged their shoulders and looked at each other and thought, well, how do we do that? We've nothing but 5 loaves and 2 fish. How is that going to feed all of these people? And yet, Jesus forges ahead. He doesn't let them off the hook. Disciples thought they were off the hook with only 5 loaves and 2 fish. But he puts them right back on the hook. Because Jesus involves the disciples in the distribution of the food he blessed. And not only did he give them the responsibility of passing out the food, he also gave them the responsibility of being on the cleanup committee. Is there a lesson for us today? I sure hope there is. It means that if we want to be genuine disciples of Jesus Christ, we too must be ready and willing to feed the hungry by responding to the command that Jesus gave not only to his disciples, but the command that he gives us to give them something to eat ourselves. According to statistics that were compiled by Bread for the World, there are 822 million people experiencing hunger throughout the world on any given day. 40 plus million of those people reside in the United States. And nearly 15% of all American households experience hunger. And of that 15% of American households, it includes almost 12 million children. Throughout the world, there are 16,000 children, roughly, who die from hunger each day. If you break it down, that means that every 5 seconds, a child dies from hunger. Certainly, an alarming realization. If we want to be genuine disciples of Jesus Christ, then we have to attune our minds and hearts to God's Word. And that means that we have to decide to act quickly and decisively. Apathy toward the hunger of another person by simply raising our hands in dismay or voicing the responsibility for the world hunger on the shoulders of others is not an option. And prayers alone are not enough. If it merely wishes another well, but does nothing to translate those good wishes into food. The issues of hunger throughout the world are oftentimes on our evening news reports. And maybe when we see these reports of human hunger throughout the world, they are so disturbing that we don't know where to begin, or maybe we don't know how to address the problem. And maybe, just maybe, we're like the disciples that Jesus had, wondering how we are going to feed all these people with 5 loaves and 2 fish. You know what? The gospel of Jesus Christ proclaims that God can and will accomplish miracles, even though our efforts may be limited or meager. Mother Teresa often preached about hunger, hunger for God, hunger for food. And someone once said to her, "I don't have enough money to feed or to cure the world's problem of hunger. What do I do?" She says, "If you can't feed 100 or 1,000, she said, "then feed just one." And I plagiarized this part from John that I went out to dinner with last night. It's really what one man did. And I'm sure that many of you at least heard of him, or perhaps read his biography. In the 1930s, there was a very short Italian immigrant with the nickname of the Little Flower. He once was the mayor of New York City. Anybody know who he is?
Why?
Fiorello DiGiorgio. He was an inspirational leader riding on the fire trucks with those who served the city safety. During a newspaper strike, he is said to have read on the radio every Sunday morning the comics to the children, probably those who wished that they were still children. He also befriended many orphans, taking them to the Yankee baseball games when he had the time. One night at the height of the Great Depression in 1935, he went to one of the poorest areas of the city. He entered the courthouse and gave the judge the night off. Can you imagine going into somebody's courtroom and say, "You can go home, I'm taking over"? He took over as judge and listened to the first case of that evening. And the first case was the grandmother, somewhat elderly woman, was charged with stealing. And she was asked, "Did you steal a loaf of bread?" She said, "Yes. I took a loaf of bread to feed my grandchildren. Their father had run off, and their mother is ill. They were hungry, and I had no money to buy food for them." The mayor appealed to the owner of the store to drop the charges, an act of mercy perhaps, but he refused. He said it would lead him to have a reputation of leniency, and that it might lead others to shoplift. And the store owner thought that it would make him look as though he failed in the neighborhood.
Judge LaGuardia realized that what the store owner had said was true. The fine was a choice of $10 cash or 10 days in jail. And so he imposed the $10 fine, knowing that the woman wouldn't pay. And so he took off his hat, put the $10 fine into the hat, and said, "I am fining everyone this evening in this courthouse 50 cents for living in a city that forces a grandmother to steal a loaf of bread and to keep her grandchildren from suffering." The hat was passed around to everyone, including the red-faced store owner. $49.50 was collected from the petty criminals, the police, the attorneys, and the reporter. And all that was given to the grandmother. And then everyone gave Judge LaGuardia a standing ovation. Isn't this the type of miraculous power you and I are called to experience and to be part of? Jesus told his disciples and tells us time and time again to give people something to eat ourselves. I pray that God may give us the grace, the courage to carry on that same mission. Jesus feeds us with his body and blood every time that we gather here at the Eucharist. And the reason that he does that is certainly for our own welfare, but also that we might go into the world and help feed others. We can't feed a whole lot of people. Maybe we can feed just one. Thank you. Believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Amen. And now may we bring our prayers and petitions before the Lord, who answers all our needs.
That our response this evening will be, "Lord, hear us, Lord." For the Church, we may continually rededicate ourselves to feeding the hungry, satisfying the thirsty, clothing the naked, welcoming the stranger, caring for the ill, and visiting the imprisoned, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
The leaders across the country and around the world may work together to eradicate hunger, homelessness, and poverty in every city, town, and nation, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
Those who work on farms and ranches, on the sea or in factories to provide food for the world, for these we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For those who are unable to join us around this table, and for those who bring the Eucharist to them, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
That we may be a welcoming community, always inviting those with sincere hearts to join us at our feast, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
The sick of our parish and all the names listed in our prayer list, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
Those who have died, especially Marianne Van Ragman, Audrey Zoschak, and our last intention for all parishioners, that they may enjoy the fullness of Christ's resurrection, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For all the prayers that we hold in this For all our intentions spoken and unspoken, for these two we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
Let us remember the hungry throughout the world, that through motivation from the gospel, followers of Christ may tend to their hunger and alleviate their pain, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
Let us remember all those who continue to suffer and experience the ravaging effects of COVID-19, that the Lord will comfort their families, comfort them, give strength to their caregivers, and also give people the impetus they need to be respectful and responsible so that they may remain safe, we pray.
Yes, Lord.
Almighty and ever-loving God, may your generosity to us always be a model and inspiration to us as we strive to live your gospel each day. We ask you to be attentive to the needs that we place before you, and to grace us with all good gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
By the way, John got an A for that project.
Sure.
Father, glory, Hosanna,
know that you love the human race and that you always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed too is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup again and gave you thanks. And giving the cup to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, be shed for you and for many, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
Deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord.
Lord, we pray, from every evil, keep us always free from harm. Protect us from anxiety, distress, and sin, whatever may lead us to sin, so that we may wait as a joyful people in hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Do not look upon our sins and failings, but rather on our faith and the faith of your church. Graciously grant to us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be always with you.
My brothers and sisters, let us offer to each other a sign of Christ's holiness.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God,
accomplish our